Every year, the IMF publishes something called the External Sector Report, which looks at two key indicators important to global economic stability. The first indicator is a measure of how much countries are importing versus how much they export. That margin of difference creates either current account deficits or surpluses. The second thing we review is changes in the level of external assets, which is how much a country owns in other countries, and we compare that to how much it's owed by other countries. That's called its external liabilities. This year, as part of the External Sector Report, or ESR, we're highlighting the risks from historically high stock imbalances. But what do we mean by stock imbalances? To answer that, let's look at two countries, Canada and Germany. Both countries have a current account. A current account is a total value of their transactions with the rest of the world. If you export more than you import, you have a surplus. If you are buying more than you're selling, you run a deficit. Now, suppose Canada runs a current account deficit. Canada has a few options for how to do that. One, it can sell or issue more government or private sector debt that individuals or countries can buy. Two, Canada can get foreign direct investments in the form of shares in a public or private company. We call that equity. Or three, it can spend from its foreign exchange reserves. But if Canada is running a current account deficit, someone else is running a current account surplus. Let's say that's Germany. In that case, Germany can use its savings to purchase the debt or equity that Canada is issuing. That leads to a buildup of equity or foreign assets or foreign exchange reserves for Germany. Since the 1990s, the global amount of external assets and liabilities has ballooned by 300%, both in gross and net terms. Economists often call this trend the rise of stock imbalances. While this increase may mean economies are integrating, which is desirable, it can also point to risks, especially for those countries that owe a lot of debt. The biggest concern is that when a country builds up a lot of external debt relative to the size of its economy, it may not be able to repay it if there's an economic downturn. Debt isn't always bad, though. It can help finance important investments like hospitals construction or broadband networks. But it's important for countries to limit the debt they take on in foreign currencies and to have enough foreign reserves to protect it from economic downturns. We also find that in countries that already have external vulnerabilities, including high debt and low reserves, growth drops faster when a downturn happens. An important concern during the COVID-19 pandemic is that debt ratios are rising while foreign exchange reserves are falling, which could lead to trouble. Overall, being a large borrower or a large lender carries risks. After all, when a borrower finds itself unable to repay its debt, creditors suffer as well. You can dig deeper into our analysis of these issues by checking out this year's External Sector Report.